Indie Mogul.
Just when you thought you were out, Twilight Mania pulls you back in. Yep, the first trailer for Twilight Eclipse has hit the web, and to celebrate, I'm going to give you a rundown of the new movie and the Twilight movie franchise. Oh, and if you haven't seen the new trailer yet, the link's in the video description. Now I'm going to discuss the following three areas, so here's your table of contents. You can click on what you're interested in watching, or you can just sit back and enjoy the whole show. See you on the other side of this transition. When the original Twilight hit theaters in 2008, it made Robert Pattinson, well, the new Zac Efron, including co-star turned real-life girlfriend. But while Pattinson spent all his time running away from his fans and talking about how he never washed his hair, Taylor Lautner hit the gym. The result, unveiled in the Twilight Saga New Moon, was a walking nightmare for Pattinson, and the two quickly became the yin and yang of teen heartthrobs. While Pattinson strives to be taken seriously with the upcoming tearjerker Remember Me and a role in an indie western opposite Hugh Jackman and Rachel Weisz, Lautner is going the Robert Downey Jr. franchise-a-palooza route. Which is the better strategy? Only time will tell, but Lautner is the one who was at the Academy Awards. As for Kristen Stewart, she had the biggest career of the three going into the Twilight movies, and she continues on her path to become the next Jodie Foster, hooker role and all. The new kid on the block for this movie is Bryce Dallas Howard, taking over the role of Victoria from Rachelle Lefevre. By the way, this is a pet peeve of mine, replacing actresses in a franchise and trying to pass them off as the same character like they did in The Mummy 3 and The Dark Knight. Women are not interchangeable. And besides, Bryce Dallas Howard is a franchise killer. Twilight Saga Eclipse is sporting the series' third director in so many movies, David Slade. Slade's previous films are Hard Candy and 30 Days of Night, which I felt made him an exciting choice for Twilight. Yet from the trailer, the movie looks exactly like the other two Twilight films. Is this a bad thing? Does Harry Potter have the right idea allowing its different directors to make their own stylistic choices, or is Twilight a brand not to be messed with? As for the story this time around, despite a marriage proposal from Edward, Bella seems to still be torn between him and Jacob. Can she really tease these boys and us for a whole nother movie? Well, I guess it worked for Archie, so why not? But we know that she does make up her mind for the final book, which will be released as two separate movies shot back to back. And while I've never read the books, I've heard from many that the final book is what makes the whole series worthwhile. But does that kind of long payoff work in movies as well as it does on the page? Will fans be patient, or will many of you sit this one out as you wait for Breaking Dawn? Write your thoughts down below. You have to be impressed with how fast they're able to churn these movies out. Whereas Harry Potter comes out pretty much every year or so, which itself is admirable, Summit Entertainment is significantly speeding up its timetable with Eclipse hitting theaters just 6 months after New Moon. Is that because they feel the craze will die out, or are fans just that hungry for more? We'll find out on June 30th, 2010 when the Twilight Saga Eclipse hits theaters because, hey, it's got a lot to live up to box office-wise. The first Twilight opened with $69 million, went on to gross $192 million in the U.S., and a worldwide total of $384 million. The Twilight Saga New Moon opened to the tune of $142 million, went on to gross $296 million in the U.S., and a worldwide total of $706 million. That makes New Moon the most successful teen romance movie in history, the most successful vampire movie in history, the most successful werewolf movie in history, and the most successful romantic fantasy movie in history. Although I think it's really stretching things to call romantic fantasy its own genre. But I digress. The point is, Twilight has made a crapload of money, especially for a franchise that's got such a love-hate relationship with audiences. One would assume the franchise is in real danger of hitting a serious road bump sooner or later. But that's when everyone said about a post-Titanic James King of the World Cameron making Avatar. And we all know how that turned out. Plus, the Twilight Saga Eclipse will be the first Twilight film to play on IMAX, and those elevated ticket prices will push those box office numbers even higher. Will Breaking Dawn, complete with sex scene and vampire birth, be in 3D? Ka-ching and ooh! So that's BTT Spotlight on the Twilight Saga Eclipse. And be sure to check back when the movie opens to hear what audiences are saying about it. I'm Grace Randolph, and while I like the first Twilight, I don't know if I can sit through another one of these movies after New Moon.